Rumors have been circulating about the existence of the Megalodon. But before we dive into this mystery, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and turn on notifications. You'll be the first to know about our new releases. Many skeptics doubt that the Megalodon ever existed, but we know that this giant shark roamed the oceans 23 million years ago, and its existence is confirmed by fossil remains. Megalodon, whose name translates to big tooth, did indeed have impressive size. Its teeth were up to 6.7 inches long, and the shark itself could be over 59 feet long. Just imagine, this predator was 3 times the size of a great white shark. When people first discovered Megalodon teeth, they thought they were stones that had fallen from the moon. Years later, naturalists linked the fossils to sharks, and then to the Megalodon. Scientists estimate that the Megalodon's bite could be as strong as 18 tons. That's about 5 times stronger than the bite force of Tyrannosaurus, one of the most fearsome predators of antiquity, which is estimated at only 3.5 tons. It makes you wonder if Megalodon could have survived and still been undetected in the depths of the oceans. The stories of the giant squid, which was also thought to be just a myth until it was discovered in 2006, show that the ocean still holds many mysteries. One potential habitat for the Megalodon could be the Mariana Trench, the deepest point of the world's oceans. It reaches a depth of 6.8 miles, and the conditions here are pretty extreme. High pressure, complete darkness, and water temperatures of about 34-39 degrees Fahrenheit. But even in such extreme conditions, viable organisms such as holothurians and ghost octopuses have been found. Could the Megalodon be hiding in its depths, undetected by humans? If the Megalodon did exist today, it would have had to adapt to radically altered living conditions. It might have become a deep-sea predator, feeding on large deep-sea squid or even other large sea creatures. If the Megalodon had evolved to survive in the Mariana Trench, it would likely have become a bioluminescent giant, living for hundreds of years and feeding on transparent deep-sea creatures. In 2012, filmmaker James Cameron became one of only 3 people to descend into the Challenger Deep, the deepest part of the Mariana Trench. With so few data points, it's impossible to know what truly inhabits the trench's depths. We can only speculate whether the Megalodon exists today or whether its extinction was terminal. Modern scientific evidence doesn't yet confirm its existence, but the ocean remains one of the most unexplored places on our planet. What about the Loch Ness Monster? It lives in a lake that's easier to explore. Plus, tons of people have seen it, and we have photos of the monster. Unfortunately, rumors and photos are not conclusive proof. Still, what do we know about this mysterious animal, and can he still live in the lake? Legends about Nessie appeared back in the mid-20th century, when locals and tourists began to report unusual encounters with the huge creature. For decades, scientists and people who love mysteries have been trying to figure out what this creature is using photos, videos, sonar, and even underwater cameras. But every time it seems like we're getting close to solving the mystery, Nessie just slips away, leaving us with more questions. Like the Megalodon, Nessie has been the subject of many theories. Some say it's a dinosaur that somehow survived to the present day. Others suggest it's a giant eel or a species of fish that's unknown to science. But despite all the efforts, no proof of Nessie's existence has ever been found. But that doesn't stop enthusiasts and scientists from keeping an eye on the lake. In recent years, they've been doing lots of research using DNA analysis of the lake's water to find out what species live in Loch Ness. It's interesting to note that some of the results showed a significant amount of eel DNA, which is food for thought. Could Nessie be a large eel? Or is this just another twist in the maze of Loch Ness mysteries? There are so many theories and speculations, but still no confirmation. Could Nessie really exist? Or is it just a myth created to attract tourists? What do you think? There's another equally mysterious and poorly understood place on Earth that could have preserved prehistoric monsters. I'm talking about the Amazon forests. For many centuries, these forests have been hiding secrets. But one of the most exciting ones is whether dinosaurs still live here. The Amazon rainforest is one of the most biodiverse places on the planet. Hundreds of species of insects, fish, snakes, and birds are discovered here every year. The dinosaurs that ruled the Earth during the Mesozoic era disappeared about 65 million years ago. But the Amazon jungle still has the right conditions for isolated dinosaur populations, lots of unexplored areas, and a stable climate. As time went on, people who lived in the jungle and travelers who went there told us about strange creatures they had seen. The descriptions sounded like pterosaurs, long-necked creatures like brachiosaurs, and other ancient animals, However, none of these observations have ever been scientifically confirmed. Most scientists doubt the possibility of dinosaurs surviving. They point to the lack of evidence, such as fossils or reliable photographs, and the fact that dinosaurs as a class would have been spotted by modern means of observation. However, those who believe in the dinosaur survival theory say that the region is not yet fully explored. A lot of the jungle is still unexplored, and there are many species of animals and plants waiting to be discovered. The question of whether these creatures survived and adapted to the new conditions is still open. I doubt that they were able to do so, but there are likely many more undiscovered species in the oceans and jungles. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.